What's going on, guys? Jeff here, and in this video we're gonna be doing heated driveway installation part two. And the reason why we can do part two is because part one has been a viral sensation on my channel, my top video. And it's honestly, guys, it's all because you guys have been hitting the like button for the YouTube algorithm. So thank you so much, and let's make this video go viral again too. Okay, so we're on the side of the house here. If you remember from last video, we got the manifold up here, and basically what we're doing is going to be installing a pipe. Don't mind all the drawings from the summer, all the way over so that we can get the water up to the manifold and down to my maintenance room in here. So that is today's mission for part two. And before any keyboard warriors want to say you can't go on the outside, we are going to insulate it as well too with PVC pipe. Yes, this will be insulated. Relax. Just kidding. Much love, you guys. So many comments on the last video. Plenty of ways to skin the cat.
Say hi.
Okay. So after you cut the pipe, you want to clean the pipe so that there's no oils on it, so that after you can get a good bond with the solder. If you didn't know already, I am not a plumber. With 3/4 inch pipes, you want to be cleaning about 3/4 inches, half pipe, half. So we have to go from our manifold, which has a threaded fitting, to our copper pipe, which we'll be soldering. Because the threaded bushing is 1 inch and our copper pipe is 3/4 inch, in order to do that, we're gonna take a reducing coupling to take us from 1 inch down to 3/4 inch. So just simply, we're gonna be putting this in here and soldering, and then we'll be putting the piece of pipe we cut into the 3/4 end of the coupling. Make sure not to touch this part with your hands. So the threaded part will be threaded into the manifold once I remove the plug, but then I don't want to solder too close to my manifold. So this way we can solder the pipe in the garage, let it cool down, and then once it's cool, we can come back out here and attach it to the manifold. And that will allow us to solder the rest of the pipe without damaging any of the manifold. So with the T-tape, you wanna make sure you put it around the right way so it doesn't come unraveled. So make sure you start on the bottom. Okay, so we're just measuring out 42 inches here for the ring stays. Just dry fitting the pipe. You want to make sure you're maintaining a slope. One. If you go too fast, it'll strip the concrete. So make sure you take it nice and easy.
Oh, I gotta stretch here.
That's level. So you wanna make sure the bubble is this way because we want the slope going down that way. There you go. All right, so we're drilling through to get the water lines to the boiler. We did it. Thanks for watching the video, guys. I still have to do the boiler, so make sure you guys are subscribed to the channel. I'll be doing a part 3 on this channel very shortly about the boiler, and we'll be rocking and rolling, providing it snows, and I'll show you the heated driveway in full effect. But you guys gotta be subscribed to the channel, so make sure you guys are subscribed to my journey. So I'd like to defend myself a little bit because I was getting quotes for this for around 20 grand, and all in, I'm gonna be close to about 10 grand on this entire project. So if you've seen the first video and then this video, that's where I'm kinda at right now. So I think that's pretty good. Maybe you guys can get it cheaper. Let me know down in the comment section if you can find it cheaper. Also ran into a lot of lockdown issues trying to do this. I will sit down and do a full cost analysis video as well on a separate video. And speaking of money, make sure you guys use my link to Wealth Simple. It's in the link in the description, and you can get $10 of free stocks when you deposit $100 and start trading within the app. It's a zero commission trading app. Also, if you haven't already, make sure you guys hit the like button, and we'll see you guys on the next video. Bye.